pleasant good morning to everyone. We get the microphones up a little bit more. So I say a pleasant good morning to everyone as you come in. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I as well have not been in front of you for a couple years, so I am not sure what the protocol, if we just shout and scream, if we just, you know, just a little applause, or we just a gentle good morning. I am not sure. Could I ask you to stand with me as we begin this morning in worship? I know some have on masks and some don't have on masks, so I'm not sure. Is everyone good for singing this morning? Is everyone good for worship this morning?
Amen.
Let me hear you sing.
Yeah.
I hear some on this side. Let me hear the rest of everyone on this side. Let me hear you go. Oh, sorry for the ladies. Your turn. Well, you're building into this boy. Wow, we coming in, we coming in. All right, for the rest of the men on the, the rest of the men. Let me hear you. All right, let me hear for the ladies now. Well, you're coming in, you're coming in nicely. Let's try it. Wade in the water. Sing wade in the water. You gotta wade in the water, children. Wade in the water. Oh, oh, oh. Christ gonna trouble.
Trouble the world.
Shores again. He's no stranger to our shores, is he? So welcome, Dr. Courtney B. want to welcome Alexander and Dr. Sheila Holas. Welcome, welcome. We have someone very dear to my heart, Linville Miller, who is visiting from New Jersey. And Linville Miller is the fiance of our very own Devon Kwow. So let's give them a warm welcome, everybody.
Today is a very special day. I mean, many of us have been longing for this day. You know, in, we're about to recognize deacons and a teacher. You know, in scripture it reads, in Romans chapter 12, it reads, "Therefore I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifice, a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship." You know, worship is really giving yourselves over to God in service. And it's physical, we do it one to another. And later on in verse 6, it says, "We have different gifts according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophesying," and we have some who tell the word of God out there, "then prophesy in accordance with your faith. If it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach." You know, we have brothers here who have served in the capacities of being a deacon and teaching, and today we recognize them. You know, it's fitting that we do that. Paul also writes in 1 Thessalonians, he says, "Now we ask you, brothers and sisters, to acknowledge those who work hard among you, who care for you in the Lord, and who admonish you. Hold them in the highest regard and love because of their work. Live in peace with each other." And today that's what we're doing. This is true worship. Acknowledging those who serve among us. We are so grateful for their service and we recognize them today. We're not saying they're the only ones, but we recognize them. At this time, let's pray.
Please pray with me. Before I pray, I also want to acknowledge Pat Williams, who has been, who was one of ours, who went to Jamaica, and she's visiting, or she's back here in Trinidad with us. So welcome, Pat, wherever you are. And Maxwell and Althea, Brent Harris, are also here from Tobago. Welcome. Yeah, let's pray together. Lord God, we worship you this morning. We're grateful for your faithfulness to us. God, in this auditorium, all our heads are bowed and our hearts are bowed before you. Oh, sovereign Lord, we ask that you bless every aspect of the service. We pray that the songs that we sing, songs of worship, will be unto you. We pray that you hear every prayer that's been offered up to you even right now in the hearts of every man and woman here. We ask that the service will go as you will have it go. But at the end of it, God, we ask that you be, we want that you be glorified. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let us pray again. Father, we worship you today. We use our very bodies. Thank you for raising up men and women amongst us. And it's in your name we pray. Amen.
Let's all stand as we continue worshiping God this morning.
continue in worship. We sing Shout to the Lord. This is the opportunity where you get to turn off phones or distractions or whispers in your ears for anything else other than just to worship.
My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. You're my comfort,
my comfort.
You're my shelter,
my shelter,
my tower.
Thank you.
days are held in your hands, crafted into your perfect plan. Your Holy Spirit, teach me, dear Lord, to live all of my life through your eyes. I'm captured by, your holy calling. Send me apart, I know you're drawing. Me to your stand. Lead me, Lord, I pray. Come on and take me. Come on and mold me. Use me, Lord, use me. Fill me. I give my life. Potter's hand, come on and call, come on and guide me, lead me, lead me, walk beside, I give my life to the potter's hand. Potter's above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and pleasures of the earth. There's no way to measure what you're worth. Oh, 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 crucified, laid behind a stone, oh my Lord, you lived to die. Rejected and alone, like a rose, trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above all. Laid behind the stone, oh my Lord, you lived to die. Rejected and alone, like a rose, trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above all. Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Crucified, laid behind the stone, oh my Lord, you lived to die. Rejected and alone, like a rose, trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above all. Laid behind the stone, oh my Lord, you lived to die. Rejected and alone, like a rose, trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above all.
At this time, we're going to have some worship videos, so please remain standing. You want to continue worshiping God while we retreat.
Let the Spirit of the Lord,
let it rise
among us. Let the Spirit of the Lord,
let it rise.
Let the glory of the Lord,
let the Chapter 11, verses 23 to 26. It reads, "For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, also he took the cup after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.'" You know, the important thing from this scripture to remember is to remember. You know, as we take the communion, our hearts has to be in a place of reverence for God. I think it's important for us to also remember that it's our sins, your sins and my sins, that put Jesus on the cross. And he came down from his high place in heaven and showed us love on that cross. Now that love is greater than any love we could even think or imagine. No man, no woman, nobody could love you as much as that, to offer you their lives, you know. And he is the king, and he came down to our level to show us his great and deep love. You know, some of the songs we just sang, we saw that what some of the lyrics we sang was, "Nothing compares to the promise I have in you. You took the fall and thought of me." So when we're tempted to feel alone, to feel rejected, to feel like there's nothing for us, there's a love that is so boundless, that is so great, and that love is found in Jesus Christ. I'll allow Portia to share at this point in time.
Good morning, everyone. For me, when I think of communion, my first remembrance of me taking communion or anything like that was in primary school. I went to Anglican primary school, and for me, it was a snack. I'm going up, I'm going to take the bread, drink the wine, and as I got older and I got baptized, I understood that this is not a tradition. It's so much more than a tradition. It's just God really saying, I am going to give everything just to show how much I love you. He gave his son. The bread represents his body, which was beaten and bruised for me, for you. And his blood that was shed while just up on the cross. And for me, this taking communion is not only just that a remembrance of that, but also it's part of community. Communion, community, that's part of the word. We take it together. That's what it's for, to bring unity as well. Even on a day like today, we have so many people. We have people here in the building and also online. We have people regionally and internationally watching and taking communion along with us. That's to show the importance of God's love and what he can do, just bringing people together through communion.
You know, what Portia shared was very important. This is more than just a tradition. Christ came, he was hit in his face, he was called all sorts of names, he was whipped, he was put on a cross, thorns, and yet still he died for his enemies. Imagine that. We wouldn't even want to talk to people who are enemies, but you know what? He died for his enemies. We were his enemies. So as we take the communion, let us remember Christ's great and deep love. Join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, Almighty God, thank you so much for bringing us together as the body of Christ, as a vast community, Lord, as your church. Father God, as we take the communion, allow us to remember your great and deep love. That when we are tempted to feel alone and feel like there's nothing for us in this world, God, Father God, your love surpasses all that. And I pray, God, that we remember that your love is so, so great, Father, that you died for us while we were still your enemies. Father God, please bless our hearts, bless us as we take the communion and remember you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Atmosphere is changing, nothing stays the same. Heaven is waiting for the mansion of the name. The Spirit is moving, burning like a flame, healing the broken by the one we proclaim. Raise it up, fill the sky. Chains will fall, mountains move, we lift him high. Speak the name above all other names. Speak the name the wind and waves obey. Jesus. Chains will fall, mountains move, we lift him high. Speak the name above all other names. Speak the name the wind and waves obey. All of heaven's coming down, fill the earth with the sound of the name of Jesus. Of the name of Jesus. Strongholds are broken, I've been made free, I am forgiven, so fear has to leave. Strongholds are broken, I've been made free, oh, I am forgiven, and fear has to leave, 'cause your name is healing, your name is power, your name is holy, my strong, strong tower. Wonderful name, glorious name, powerful name of Jesus, Jesus. Speak the name above all other names. Speak the name the wind and waves obey. All of heaven's coming down, fill the earth with the sound of the name of Jesus, of the name of Jesus. Speak the name of Jesus. Amen.
Sanctified.
Good morning, church. How's everybody doing? It is an honor and a pleasure for me to be here. For those who don't know me, my name is Angel Martinez, and I bring you greetings from the Dominican Republic. And I just want to say thank you for the opportunity of being able to be here. I know Nino was working his thing behind the scenes and insisting, and got a group of us to be able to make it out here. But I just wanted to say thank you for this opportunity to be here, and it is a privilege to be here for such a moment as this. It's a special moment here for Trinidad and Tobago, and to see the appointment of a teacher as well as deacons. And just want to share real quickly, Tyrone, I'm so proud of you. You know, your dedication to the teaching ministry. Me and Tyrone go way back to when we were much younger men. We would be able to play four games of basketball and still be able to walk afterwards. But your dedication to the teaching ministry, you know, the Damien Jean-Baptiste School of Missions, we talked about him. I know he's smiling down from heaven. He would be so proud of you, proud of the both of you. You know what I mean? And what he has done, your dedication to the kingdom, to use your talents, to use your gifts, your love for God, your love for his church. And so I just wanted to say thank you. Thank you, and congratulations. It is a special day. And I thank my God that I can be here to see it. I was not able to see to be there at Courtney's. There were different things. It was around that time that Damien had passed, and I don't think it's coincidence. This week was Damien's birthday, just for some of you who know, Thursday of this week. So I think God orchestrated these things for a reason, but very proud of you, Courtney, Dr. Courtney Bailey. I can say I knew him before he was famous. I knew him before he was, but I just want to say I thank God for you. And I thank God for your hearts and what you do and how you serve. So God bless. I love you a ton. Thank you very much. But just wanted to share a couple of quick pieces of good news from the Dominican Republic. We're back to meeting for church midweek Sundays. We're back in the thick of things over there. Praise God. It's been good to be with one another. This weekend, as we are here, about 190 teens and campus students from the Dominican Republic and Puerto Rico are having a retreat in the Dominican Republic. And it has been exciting to see what God is doing with the youth, what God is doing with our campus and teen ministry. So please be praying that through this weekend, we can see a lot of fruit that will come of it. And it's just been great to see what God's been doing among them. Another thing that's been going on is I asked for your, during the time of COVID, even though it was a very difficult time and a very challenging time, we were in the middle of a construction of a second building. We have a group that meets in the east part of Santo Domingo, and it's about 200 disciples. It's been difficult for years to be able to find a meeting place. So you can imagine COVID came around, we locked everything down, but because of God and because of we were able to actually save money during COVID, the East building was inaugurated about 3 months ago, and the disciples, a little over 200 disciples are meeting there. They had close to 400 people in that first service at their building, so it's been definitely God working in the middle of all this. A couple of quick things. During COVID, we also had about 20 weddings in the Dominican Republic. You would think married during COVID, it was cheaper. Definitely that was a fact. Just come on Zoom, so a lot of people took advantage of that. So there's a lot going on there. And lastly, I just ask something that's been that's incredible. I ask you to pray specifically for this your sister in the Dominican Republic. Her name is Dr. Ansel Shecker. She's been working for the Ministry of Education for close to a little over 20 years. On numerous occasions, she was asked to become the Vice Minister of Education for the Dominican Republic, over 3 million students. And on this occasion, she actually accepted it. So your sister is now the Vice Minister of this. She had been hesitant to accept the position because many of you know in our countries, it's a very political position. But pray that God can use her to reach out as you know to the kings and all these other people that perhaps we cannot reach out to, but she can, so that it can give glory to God as she impacts the students for Jesus. Thank you very much for this time. God bless. And again, congratulations, my brother.
Good morning, church. Thank you, Portia. I was a little too eager. All right, let's do it again. Good morning, church. So today is a great day in the church. I think so. It's a day of joy, a day of celebration, as we recognize and appoint teacher and deacons, respectively. You know, on a day like this, we look forward to the songs of worship. And I think they have been really sweet so far. We have had some fantastic singing, fantastic worship. We are excited about that. We look forward to the fellowship. For some of us, it may be the first time that we are coming out in in-person service in years because of COVID. The fellowship is sweet. It is joyful. We desire communion with our brothers and sisters. But let me ask a question. Do we look forward to the offering with the same joy? Or is it that, oh man, we're going to talk about money now. Dollars start to fly out of your head. You know, we're going to talk about that. You know, I think we need to capture God's heart about giving. Our God is a very generous and joyful giver. We see that all the time. And that's the heart that he wants us to have. And I want to look this morning at a man and of people who were able to capture that heart of God, the Israelite King David. You know, the background to this is that David, King David, had helped to fund the building of the temple to the Lord from his personal resources. The leaders of Israel followed suit and gave willingly and wholeheartedly. And the people of Israel followed their leaders. And King David said this prayer in 1 Chronicles 29, reading from verse 10 to verse 14. This is what David says. David praised the Lord in the presence of the whole assembly, saying, "Praise be to you, Lord, the God of our father Israel, from everlasting to everlasting. Yours, Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the majesty and the splendor, for everything in heaven and earth is yours. Yours, Lord, is the kingdom. You are exalted as head over all. Wealth and honor come from you. You are the ruler of all things. In your hands are strength and power to exalt and give strength to all. Now, our God, we give you thanks and praise your glorious name. But who am I and who are my people that we should be able to give generously as this? Everything comes from you, and we have given you only what comes from your hand. You see, David recognized, as he said in that verse, that wealth and honor comes from the Lord, and even our health and strength. And then he says, every single thing that we have to call our own, every blessing, every benefit comes from God. You know, Angel was just talking a little while ago about, you know, the sister in Dominic who was elevated to a high position. That's a blessing from God. Everything comes from God. Do you realize that if you only have 1 cent in your pocket right now, that cent was placed there by God? As we say in Tobago, a God put them there. With Dolores. Dolores might help me with that. I got it right. A God put on there. All right. And when we recognize this, there's joy and beauty in being able to come together and give the church and to sustain the church. The Israelites did not see this as a burden. They knew from whom all their blessings came. You know, in 2019, when I fell ill seriously and left my job, Donna and I went through significant financial challenges. On top of that, we had large medical bills to pay, but we never stopped giving consistently to the church. We always considered it a great joy to be able to give to the church, even to the poor. And God has blessed us in many ways. Since I'm going to let my beautiful wife share now.
Amen. Right, so Patrick said we never stopped giving to the church during financially difficult times. And yes, we have those too, in case you thought otherwise. But what he did not tell you was that God came through for us in various ways, and the bills were all paid. In fact, the bills were always paid. In absolute faithfulness, we never hold back from giving, no matter what. No matter all the years that we've known each other, we've never, ever stopped. There was a time when I first came to Trinidad, Patrick was the only one who was working, and it was 4 of us in the family. He had to mine, as we say in Jamaica. But we never stopped giving. We never lowered our giving, no matter what. Personally, I love giving. He could tell you, I love giving. If he says, let me give you $10, I say, give 20. You know, I love knowing that God looks down on all of us with favor when we, with willing hearts, give collectively, you know, all of us together as one body. Imagine God looking down on us when we're giving, and we're giving wholeheartedly and willingly. I know he's pleased with us, you know. So just like David and the whole assembly in First Chronicles, and just like the Macedonian and Corinthian churches, I know God says to test him in our giving, that we will be enriched in every way so that we can be generous on every occasion, that he is able to bless us abundantly so that in all things, at all times, having all that we need, we will abound in every good work. Uncle Bob Peterson always told us to take the scriptures at face value. He always said it. He says, take the scriptures at face value. And that means we need to believe what we read and live it, right? Yeah. I believe. I have proven God over and over in this, and along with you all, I will continue to give generously, whether in plenty or in want. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Stuart. You know, my prayer today is that, like King David, we would recognize that everything in heaven and earth belongs to him. It's not ours. Wealth and honor comes from him. We get a chance to show our love and gratitude by giving. It's a privilege like no other. It's a unique opportunity to show how much we love and appreciate God. Let us give generously like King David and the people of Israel. Let's pray at this time for the offering. Father, we want to thank you. We know that everything comes from you. Are you put on there? God, and we pray that as a people, we give generously in the way that you have given to us. You are a joyful giver. You are a generous giver. And I pray that we can imitate your heart as we seek to give for the sustenance of the church out of a spirit of joy and gratitude. Thank you for this opportunity. In Jesus' name we pray all these things. Amen.
Enjoying the service so far? Are the scriptures on point? Anybody verified and open their Bible and check? And that's making sure one of the things we boast about is we are Bible-believing church. And we solid on the scriptures. That matters to me very much because amidst everything, the beautiful singing, the warm people, all the bright faces, we want to make sure Jesus is Lord all the time, yes?
Amen.
And that's why we sing this song, Thank You Lord, Song 700.
Thank you, Lord, for loving me. And thank you, Lord, for blessing me. Thank you, Lord, for making me whole and saving my soul. I want to thank you, Lord, for loving me. I want to thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Let us all with one accord sing praises to Christ the Lord. Let us all unite in song and praise Him all day long. I want to thank you, Lord, for loving me. I wanna thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Please reveal your will for me so I can serve you for eternity. Use my life in every way, take hold of it too. I wanna thank you, Lord, for loving me. I wanna thank you, Lord, for saving my soul.
Verse 1.
Thank you, Lord, for loving me, and thank you, Lord, for blessing me. Thank you, Lord, for making me whole and saving my soul. I wanna thank you, Lord, for loving me. I wanna thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. I wanna thank you, Lord, for loving me.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. It is definitely a pleasure to see you all this morning. For those of us who are online with us, it's great to have you as well. It is very clear that there's a buzz in the air because there's much to celebrate and much joy that we all feel this morning. I hope to guide our thinking as we consider what we are about to witness this morning. You know, it is a great day today. And we're going to be appointing 3 deacons here and 1 teacher. So we pull out the big stops this morning, lapel mic and stuff. So. My microphone working? Yes. Okay, good. Perfect. You know, I wanted to share some brief comments on the role of a deacon. In Acts chapter 6, a very famous passage, and the teachers are here to correct me this morning, but it's all good. I think I'll be in good stead. In verse 1 through 7, it reads, "In those days when the number of disciples were increasing, the Hellenistic Jews among them complained against the Hebraic Jews because their widows were being overlooked in the daily distribution of food. So the 12 gathered all the disciples together and said, it would not be right for us to neglect the ministry of the word of God in order to wait on tables. Brothers and sisters, choose 7 men from among you who are known to be full of the Spirit and wisdom. We will turn this responsibility over to them and will give our attention to prayer and the ministry of the word. This proposal pleased the whole group. They chose Stephen, a man full of faith and of the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas from Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid their hands on them. So the word of God spread. The number of disciples in Jerusalem increased rapidly, and a large number of priests began to be obedient, or became obedient to the faith. You know, while in this passage, the word deacon is not mentioned, most scholars agree that the situation was the beginning or a prototype of the role. The Greek word for deacon is diakonos. It simply means servant. Servant. And that's what Stephen, Philip, and the other men did. They served by making sure the sisters of Greco-Jewish background were not overlooked when it came to the portion of food or the portioning of food and the distribution of it. In doing so, they relieved the apostles from meeting this practical need in the church so that they could focus their attention on prayer and the ministry of the word. So, the brothers were appointed to this service because of a need in the congregation. You know, I wanted to clarify this because many of us may have come from church backgrounds where the role of a deacon is one of power, of authority, and leadership, instead of service at the request of the leadership. You know, deacons are the servant ministers of the church. Deacons have the honor of modeling for the church and the lost Jesus' heart for service. So, I understand that there may be some confusion when it comes to maybe Philip, for example, who was chosen to serve the widows. But most of what we know about him was that the role of an evangelist, right? So he, in this case, was multi-gifted. See, we have a similar thing here in the Port of Spain Church of Christ, as we will see this morning. And I give the names of our brothers Neil Carrington, Michael London, and Jovie Lord. These men, yes. These men do serve as they lead small groups, right? You know, but even though that they are being appointed deacons, these are two separate roles that they have. You know, so like I said, while it's easy to be confused by this, we have to understand that the separation does exist. As the church grows and the needs arise, it's possible to have deacons who are not family group leaders or in leadership, so to speak, right? In the same way. But with that said, we are excited, elated to honor the work alongside these men with their wives and their families, because they play a pivotal role, the women in their lives. And let's give it up for those sisters who have exemplified the heart of service found in Jesus our Lord. So before we ask those brothers to come forward, and we have a video presentation at this time, and then they will come to the stage and we'll continue with a charge and then we'll appoint them.
Greetings from Virginia and congratulations to the Port of Spain Church of Christ on the appointment of new deacons. Michael London, Gervais Lord, and Neil Carrington are all men who are full of faith in the Holy Spirit and I'm sure will be excellent flesh and blood representations of the service of Jesus, who didn't come to be served, but to serve and give his life as a ransom for many. Knowing the reputation of service that the church has throughout Trinidad and Tobago and the Caribbean, Leslie and I are looking forward to hearing all of the good news of the needs that have been met, all to God's glory. Wish we could be there in person, but may God continue to bless and keep the church as the gospel is spread throughout TNT and the rest of the Caribbean. I'm very honored today to share a few words about the men who are being appointed as deacons. The Greek word diakonos means servant or table waiter. The Bible does not say exactly what specific role or tasks the deacons perform. The Bible, however, has a lot to say about the character of the deacon. In 1 Timothy chapter 3, we see that deacons in the Lord's church are called to a very high standard. They must be worthy of respect. They must hold to the deep truths of the faith with a clear conscience. And they must stand the test of service. The Spirit has selected three men who meet the high calling of character and who are ready to be appointed as deacons. These men are Gervais Lord, Neil Carrington, and Michael London. Gervais, you gave yourself to the Lord as a young teenager. You traveled abroad to complete your education, and you returned back to Trinidad. Praise the Lord. You remained steadfast in your faith as a young man, and you gave your heart to the Lord in service to His people. I am so proud of what the Holy Spirit has done in your life and congratulate you on your appointment. Neil, you are one of the most faithful brothers in the church. You've been a faithful servant for as long as I have known you. Whenever I see you, Neil, you have this big, warm, welcoming smile, and you have always been ready to serve the church, regardless of your life stage, whether single, whether married, or as a parent. You've been a blessing to the church for several years, and the Spirit is honoring you today among your brothers and sisters. Michael, you are a dear friend who has stood by my side at a time of great adversity. You will always be very dear to me. You're a faithful friend to so many people in this church. You've offered your gifts and talents to the Lord from the day you got baptized. I fondly remember accompanying you into the studios at TV6 to work on church videos. You gave us access to a world that we had absolutely no access to. I know that God is honoring you, Michael, before the congregation, and I'm confident that you will live up to your calling. I am so proud of these men, and I know that others will soon follow in their footsteps. Robin and I also want to lift up the wives of the deacons, Nicole, Natalie, and Karen. Thank you, sisters, for helping your husbands to be the men who they are. You and your children have made sacrifices so that they can serve the saints. The appointment of deacons in the first century church is recorded in Acts chapter 6. Seven men were given the task to wait on tables. Their appointment enabled the apostles to give their attention to prayer and the ministry of the word. The scripture says that the word of God spread and the number of disciples increased rapidly. It is my profound hope that the appointment of these deacons will enable the church in Trinidad to continue to spread the gospel and that many souls will come to know Christ. To God be the glory.
Serve as an evangelist in our church for
All right, so as Paul wrote in his letter to Timothy about the office of deacon, I repeat to you this morning, Michael, Neil, and Juvie, that you must continue as men worthy of respect, sincere, not indulging in much wine, and not pursuing dishonest gain, keeping hold of the deep truths of the faith with a clear conscience. You know, I am very privileged to be able to make this appointment, and I choose not to speak much because you guys hold dear, a dear part in my own heart as friends growing up in the church. And it is an honor for me to join you guys on this journey, but to be here with Patrick and Alan and to see you guys in this role. The truth is, you guys have been deacons before. This is just us recognizing you. And our goal is to continue to help you as you help the church, so that in your growth, the church will benefit in immense ways. So, by the authority given to me from the Holy Spirit, along with the shepherds of this church, we commend you three brothers to the role of deacons. Please join with me as we pray. Okay, so come from. Join with us in prayer, church. Dear Lord, the God of all creation, and the head of our church, Father, whom you've given so much for, your bride. This morning, Father, we are elated to see how your Spirit has moved powerfully among us and has called these three men to this appointment. Father, we pray that their lives will continue to be exemplary, that they will continue to serve as they have in so many different ways. We pray this morning as they are commended to this place, this office, that they will continue to look to you and to draw their strength from you. May your Holy Spirit reside in them in a powerful way. And may we all as a church, God, be just blessed to see how you work through them. And may we see even more men raised up and women, God, to serve in your church in so many capacities. We love you, God. We thank you. We commend these men to you through your Holy Spirit. And may their offices be a blessing to the church, so we can spread the gospel to as many as possible. We love you. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. So as these guys get a little picture, we do have some presentations for them, as well as we're going to have a brief response by one of the deacons. I get to say that now. So that would be Deacon Juvie. Okay. I wouldn't tell you all. Thank you, Stefan Hines. And there is some gifts for you guys. We hope that this will encourage you and just express our gratitude to you for your service as you enter into this role. So let's give it up for our new deacons. And I hand your mic over to Deacon Juvie.
So on behalf of the deacons, we continue to be servants for the Lord and to his people, in offering these shepherds, evangelists, to focus on prayer, studying God's word, and pastoral care. Their unanimous approval, as well as their confidence that Christ, the head of the church, is calling us into service in an official capacity, is uplifting. Thank you, everyone. It is a huge honor to be appointed as deacons. And scripture makes it clear that ministering as a deacon is a rewarding and honorable calling in the church. We thank you for the smooth process and the faith you have in us.
We pray that we continue to fulfill our duties humbly and have the support of everyone to edify the church into Christ. Thank you.
Thank you, Jerby. You guys. All right. At this time, we are going to move on to the role of teacher. And I'm going to share some brief words, and we'll then have some videos that will be shared, similar to what we just did in terms of the sequence. But I was thinking about this brother. You all know who I'm talking about, right? Jules Tyrone Marcus. Yes, I gotta give the fullness, right? And there's a passage that, I don't know, the Spirit kind of led me to, and I thought, wow, this is Tyrone. And in Ecclesiastes 12, verse 9 to 10, it reads, "Not only was the teacher wise, but he also imparted knowledge to the people. He pondered and searched out and set in order many proverbs. The teacher searched to find just the right words, and what he wrote was upright and true." You know, as a teacher, Tyrone, I found these words to be very, very true about you. Your love for God's word and your skills in crafting the things that you have to share is absolutely amazing. You know, you search and you find the right words, not only to say, but to write on a blog or in your unbeatable blog. You all know Tyrone has a blog, right? Yes. But even in your book as well. And it's my pleasure to be able to witness what God is doing in your life along with your family. I mean, again, like I said before, we have some videos to share, and you kind of realize why my comments are brief, because we do have some live flesh and blood examples of brothers, or a brother who is going to share some thoughts as well later on. So today we're here to simply recognize what you have been doing for many, many years, using your gifts of teaching for the building up of God's church. And that is commendable. So at this time, I'm going to turn your attention to the screen, and we'll continue after.
Greetings again to the church and to you, Tyrone Marcus, on this very special day. Tyrone, you've always used your gifts to equip God's people for works of service, and I'm so excited to see that gift being fanned into flame today as you're recognized as congregational teacher. Your love for God's word and for his people has always been inspiring, and I pray that through your service, the church may be built up until we all become mature and attain the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. Congratulations.
Good morning, brothers and sisters in Trinidad and Tobago. So encouraging to be a part of this special day with you. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Jeff Hickman. This is my beautiful wife, Christy, and we serve at the North River Church of Christ in Atlanta, Georgia, in the U.S., and we're just excited to be a part of this special day. We know that these are unique times, and it's encouraging to know that the church is still working together, bonding and growing. We've been talking to the LaFleurs. The Channers have been connected to some of you, the Ottenwellers. It's been a great connection that we've had with the church there. And we're excited that you guys are able to appoint some deacons and a teacher today, and that you've allowed us to be a part of such a special service.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm definitely so excited to see the way that God is building up your church and blessing your church there. And I have to say, I'm not the least bit surprised when we visited. Your love, your wisdom, your encouragement, Your hospitality was just amazing. And we had such a great time with you guys. And it's really cool because our daughter Hannah has been keeping up with some of the teens from teen camp. And she actually said to send her love and her prayers. And she said she can't wait to see you guys again someday.
Hopefully someday soon.
Someday soon.
And, you know, the Bible talks in Ephesians 4, which is a passage I am sure, if it hadn't been read already, it's going to be read. But it talks about how really the Lord gave these roles to the church, and one of them being a teacher, you know. And it talks about in Ephesians 4 that if you, the church has teachers, they can equip the saints for the work of ministry and for building up the body of Christ. And I know, as I've already mentioned, I know you're appointing deacons, and I know you're appointing Tyrone as a teacher. And I'm just encouraged because Tyrone and I took the classes together in the Athens Institute of Ministry back in 2007, 2008-ish, where we were taking classes together. And I'm inspired, Tyrone, that you've made it to this. I mean, you were copying my notes and you had me write all your papers and all that stuff. And now you made, I'm just kidding. That didn't happen. I just was joking. It's okay to joke sometimes. But we all know Tyrone doesn't need any help when it comes to academic stuff, right? But that's so cool. I feel so connected. I feel so encouraged. My heart is warmed. I'm excited that you are going to be appointed a teacher in God's church, man. I'm just so happy for you, and just really for the church there. Yeah, what an amazing moment.
Mm-hmm. I'm really excited about, you know, the what Tyrone's going to bring as a teacher to the group there. But I have to tell you, his wife Michelle is pretty awesome. And I just have to share this little story because I don't know, probably not many people know, but when we were there, I got a really bad tooth infection that was very painful. And Michelle just completely took care of me. She took me immediately to her dentist on a Saturday, called, got me in somehow, helped get me some medicine. I mean, I was in a lot of pain. I was in tears pain. Took care of me, watched over me, drove me around, and just served me with sisterly love. I will just never forget that. So, yeah, Tyrone's wife is pretty awesome too. Thank you, Michelle.
It's beautiful. Men and women serving, loving, and that's what builds up the body of Christ. And that's what helps the world know that we're really disciples of Jesus. So I hope we didn't take too much time. We just wanted to tell you how much we love you here at North River. We're connected to you. And you know what? We're about to go on a date.
Yeah.
It's important. So if you're married, keep going out on dates, not just for single people. We love you. See you next time, hopefully soon. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Good morning. My name is Sean Barnes, and I serve as one of the evangelists in the New York City Church of Christ. My wife and I also served the Lord for 9 wonderful years in Trinidad and Tobago. Today is a very special day for the church in Trinidad and Tobago, for today we are witnessing the appointment of a teacher and 3 deacons. In Matthew chapter 16, after Peter's confession that Jesus is the Messiah, Jesus said this to him, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for this was not revealed to you by flesh and blood, but by my Father in heaven. And I tell you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it." Jesus said, "I will build my church." Jesus is the one who established the church in the first century, and Jesus continues to build his church today. Moreover, it is Jesus who is appointing these brothers to these specific roles. Robert and I have known Tyrone since he graduated from law school and returned to Trinidad. He has loved the Lord from the days of his youth. Tyrone has given himself to the work of the ministry and has used his talents to build up and encourage the church in Trinidad and Tobago for several years. God has used Tyrone to preach, to teach, and yes, to dance his way into our hearts. Tyrone is a true Caribbean man. Born in Guyana, converted in Barbados, married in Jamaica to a beautiful Jamaican woman, and now teaching in Trinidad. I want to take a few moments to share about Tyrone's wife, Michelle. Michelle, I commend you before the sisters as a wife of noble character. Without your support at home, Tyrone would not have had the time to do the work for which he is today being honored. I also want to give a shout out to your children, Tyrell and Jadrian. Congratulations to you both. Myself and the entire church owe you a huge thank you for sharing your daddy with us. Congratulations, Tyrone. I am so proud of you and excited to see what the Spirit will do in Trinidad and Tobago as we turn the page to the next chapter of our glorious history. I am confident that the Holy Spirit will use you powerfully. Praise be to Jesus that we are witnessing this day. Our Lord Jesus continues mightily to build his church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it.
All right. Wow. We still have some greetings coming in afterwards, but let me ask Tyrone to please come forward. Along with the deacon, well, our shepherds will be here as well. Wow, and he has his sword in hand, eh? The good teacher, boy. doesn't leave home without it, not even the pews.
Fully armed,
yes. Wow. I just have a very simple charge for you, Tyrone. And that is coming from Titus chapter 2, verse 7 to 8. It says, in everything, set an example by doing what is good. In your teaching, show integrity, seriousness, and soundness of speech that cannot be condemned, so that those who oppose you may be ashamed because they have nothing bad to say about you. Today we commend you to this role of teacher before the saints, before God and his host of angels, and we ask you to continue to use your gifts to glorify God and his church and to build up his people to his honor and to his glory. Let us pray at this time for Tyrone. Dear Lord, we are filled with joy. We thank you so much, God, that you've blessed us with our brother Tyrone. We thank you for his service to your people for these many years, and the way in which you've used his gifts. God, we thank you so much for the way in which you've fanned into flames, God, the gifts that he's had from so much years now. And God, this morning, as we commend him to this role, we ask your Spirit to continue to guide him and to raise him up. God, fill him with great humility, with a great deep sense of passion and integrity for your word, as we know he has continued to exemplify it for many, many years. We thank you for his wife, Michelle, and their children. We thank you for the role that they have played in helping him, for his family, his mom who's passed on, his dad who's still with us, and his siblings as well. We pray, God, that your Spirit will move powerfully through him. And as a church, God, we will benefit by your amazing love for us and the gifts that you've blessed us with. Thank you again for Tyrone. And as he is commended to this role, may his service to you and to your saints be just an amazing blessing to all. We love you, we thank you, and we pray these things this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Congratulations. At this time, I'm going to ask Dr. Courtney Bailey to come forward.
It's really great to be in Trinidad this morning and to be with the Port of Spain Church of Christ. I don't have time to tell you how happy I am to be here, but I'm hoping my colors this morning, even though I'm a little late for Republic Day, will convey some of the sentiments I have about being in Trinidad. I bring you greetings from the Kingston Church of Christ, who today, from the bottom of our hearts, celebrate with you. I consider myself to be privileged this morning to share with you in this moment of celebration as we recognize the gifts that God has given to our brother Tyrone. And as we affirm him in the role he has been playing and which God has called him to play in Jesus' church. It's important for me to say that this is just not a moment of recognition for Tyrone, but it is also a moment of recognition for the maturity of the Port of Spain Church of Christ in having a teaching ministry. Teachers cannot exist without students. And so the recognition of Tyrone as a teacher in the Port of Spain Church means at the same time that we're recognizing the Port of Spain Church is a church hungry to learn the deeper things of God and to mature in the faith. I know this to be true from my personal experience through sharing a small part of your teaching journey through the Caribbean School of Ministry over the past several years. And I want to affirm your maturity and your growth as a church. I don't have time to share about Michelle. I will simply say from personal experience that Tyrone could not do any of what he's done without tremendous sacrifice on her part. Michelle, I speak on behalf of Lavette and I and the Kingston Church. Thank you for loving Tyrone and supporting him in the work that he does for this church and the churches throughout the Caribbean. But today, I'm here primarily to share in your recognition of Tyrone as a teacher. I want to briefly add my voice to the chorus of others acknowledging Tyrone's giftedness and heart and character, which make him suitable for this role. The greatest teacher said that a student is not above his teacher. And so the first requirement of a teacher is that he must be a great student, which means, amongst other things, he must have the humility to learn. Tyrone is first and foremost a great student, someone with a passion to learn. He's not only a voracious reader, he is a perennially curious conversationalist, seeking to learn from everyone he encounters. This makes him not only a great model of learning and of being a student, it increases his capacity to learn, and by means thereof, his capacity to teach. One of the gifts that God has blessed him with is the ability to take in large amounts of information and complex concepts and to synthesize them and simplify them into easily understandable and accessible classes delivered in an engaging, conversational, and relatable way. In this way, as I know you can testify, he's been a blessing to God's people, not only here in Trinidad, but throughout the Caribbean and in other parts of the world. Having taught with him here in Port of Spain, as well as in Kingston, and having received reports from Christians I encounter all over the world who've heard him teach in other places in the Caribbean and around the world, I can say that Tyrone is a talented teacher gifted by God to his church. But perhaps what most importantly equips Tyrone to serve as a teacher is his heart and character. Tyrone is a deeply spiritual man who desires to please God and to love others. He's a man of integrity who desires not merely to handle God's word faithfully and to do what he's teaching others from the scripture, but to become it. Tyrone, today my heart is filled with joy as you're recognized as a teacher in your home congregation, the Port of Spain Church of Christ, which I know is dear to your heart and which you love. I'm grateful to partner with you in the teaching ministry, not only here, but in Kingston and throughout the Caribbean and wherever our God will open doors for you to use the talent that he has given you. As you continue on this journey in the teaching ministry to which God has called you, I want to read you a few words of the Apostle Paul, which you will be able to interpret and apply. Paul writes in 1 Corinthians 8, "We know that we all possess knowledge, but knowledge puffs up, while love builds up. Pride is an occupational hazard for knowledge workers. Strive to remain humble. Let love be your guiding star." Paul says in Romans 12, "For by the grace given me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment in accordance with the faith God has distributed to each of you. For just as each of us has one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ, we, though many, form one body, and each member belongs to all the others. We have different gifts, according to the grace given to us. If your gift is teaching, then teach. Love must be sincere. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. May you continue to walk with God as you seek to fulfill the role to which he has called you." And now we'll have a chance to hear from two true friends and teachers who've been instrumental in both Tyrone and my development as teachers. We're going to hear from Dr. Douglas Jacoby and from Joseph Harris.
Hello, my name is Joey Harris, and I've had the great honor and privilege of being one of Tyrone's teachers, mentors, and friends over the years. I've watched him grow in his relationships, especially with his family. I've watched him grow as a student and applying his intellect.
Watched him as he grew in his legal career, and I've watched him as he has, most of all, become a teacher. And it was with great pride and warmth that I first watched him teach in Jamaica and later in Trinidad. And I'm very honored to participate and be able to be part of Tyrone being officially appointed as a teacher. Tyrone, congratulations. God bless.
Good morning from Tallinn, Estonia. I'm Douglas Jacoby, and I'm here to say a few words of praise for my friend Tyrone Marcus. This is a teachers' conference, teaching ministry conference. Oh, if Tyrone were here, he'd be on the program enjoying the fellowship, and I know so many people would benefit from his wisdom and his knowledge into God's Word. Why do I believe Tyrone is worthy of being recognized as a teacher? Certainly, it begins with heart. And all the brothers and sisters in the teaching ministry globally agree character is the most important thing. That's not to say training isn't vital. That too is essential. And Tyrone has been training in biblical interpretation and many other important topics for a number of years, to the point that now he's a trainer biblically. Of course, he's well known in the sports world, but I'm talking about just teaching Bible. Being trained, and he trains, and I trust him. Tyrone, your impact has been not just in the Caribbean, And maybe you need to be reminded of how well you're thought of and how many people you've helped around North America and in Africa and Europe and other places. I respect you immensely, and you are to be congratulated on this day. Wish I could be with you in Port of Spain, but congratulations on your recognition as a teacher and a colleague.
At this time, we want to have a response. At this time, we want to have a response from Tyrone, but before we do that, you know, we really want to share a gift. On behalf of the Port of Spain Church of Christ, we want to present to you this wonderful gift. It's just a token of our appreciation for your hard work. We love you. Teachers teach, so let's hear it from you.
Thank you very much, everyone. Sorry. There's a verse that to me really typifies all that's happening today. It's in Ephesians 4, in verse 7. It says, "But grace was given to each one of us according to the measure of Christ's gift." When I think about today, I just feel like it's just grace being poured out to me. It's particularly emotional as I remember returning from Jamaica in 2005 and my mom saying to me, because Michelle and I had the privilege of serving in ministry in Montego Bay, and my mom saying to me, "I know you're going back into the legal profession, but with all that you've learned in Christian ministry, make sure you keep teaching." I remember I shared that back in 2014 when we launched the School of Ministry, and I think about today and my mom's vision. Mom is no longer here. She's, November makes it 10 years since she's passed on. And so I thank the sisters, Auntie Christine, Auntie Oslin, for representing Mom. Thank you. I'm glad to see my mom's vision for me fulfilled, even in her absence. Thank you. My dad wanted to make it today, but he should be watching online. Thank you, Dad and Asante, for your support. Chris, Courtney, Michelle. As someone would have shared earlier, you can't be a teacher without students. And forget the student side of things. You know, this is about a partnership, and I say thanks to every one of you for the partnership we've been able to share, and to Neil and Michael and Juve, congratulations. And I look forward to us being able to serve together. Thanks, everyone. And above all, thank God for his grace. Amen.
Thank you. It's the light that pierces through you to the darkest hidden place. It knows your deepest secrets, but it never...
I'm sorry. That pierces through you to the darkest hidden place. It knows your deepest secrets, but it never looks away. It's the gentle hand that pulls you from the judgment of the crowd. When you stand before them guilty and you've got no way. Some may call it foolish and impossible, but for every heart it rescues, it's a miracle. It's nothing less than scandalous, this love that took our place. Just call it what it is, call it grace. Call it grace. It's the breath that's breathing new life into what we thought was dead. It's the favor that takes orphans, placing crowns upon their heads. It's the hope for our tomorrows, the rock on which we stand. It's a strong and mighty fortress, even hell can stand against. Some may call it foolish and impossible, but for every heart it rescues, it's a miracle. It's nothing less than scandalous, this love that took our place. Just call it what it is, call it grace. Call it grace. Call it grace. Amazing, unshaking. This is grace, this is grace. Unchanging, unfailing. This is grace, this is grace. Some may call it foolish and impossible, but for every heart it rescues, it's a miracle. It's nothing less than scandalous that Jesus took our place. Oh, call it what it is, just call it what it is, call it grace. Amen.
Thank you, Denise. Always so graceful and awesome. Trying to keep things. Give
it up for Portia. She's just... I do have some closing thoughts to share with us this morning. And as Jeff Hickman shared, Ephesians 4 would have been a passage that we would hear. This is probably the third time I think Tyrone alluded to it, maybe even Courtney. But it says in Ephesians chapter 4, reading from verse 11, so Christ himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the pastors, and teachers to equip his people for works of service, so that the body of Christ may be built up, until we all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God, and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. Then you will no longer be infants, tossed back and forth by the waves and blown here and there by every wind of teaching and by the cunning and craftiness of people in their deceitful scheming. Instead, speaking the truth in love, we will grow up or grow to become in every respect the mature body in him who is the head, that is Christ. From him, the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love as each part does its work. A very famous passage, one that speaks to all of us this morning. Because while we do recognize these men through whom the Spirit has called, we do understand that we all too are called by Christ to use our gifts to build the church up. You know, this passage epitomizes what we have just witnessed this morning. Christ's giving the church the offices to equip his people for service. You know, Christ builds his church by appointing persons to serve in different roles in the church. The role of teacher and deacon, as we've just appointed this morning, are not just church titles. They mean something to Jesus, because he's all about his bride being radiant. The men who have been appointed today have an important role to play in the church, to be flesh or real flesh and blood examples of our Lord Jesus, and as they use their gifts of teaching and serving to do just that. Their roles is to equip the saints for works of service, to build unity, and to help the members of the church to mature spiritually. You know, as these men accomplish their work, the church gets stronger. Can I get an amen for stronger? Yeah. And to help members of the church, gets stronger, God can use it to influence more and more people. Isn't that why the church exists? To make known our Lord Jesus to as many as possible. Seeing these men appointed is a testimony of their love for this church. These are men who can be imitated and honored. I say that again. These are men who can be imitated and honored. So, yes, amen. Thank you. So, church, I urge every one of us, young Christian, old Christian, mature, young, whatever, wherever you land, you have a role to play. And I pray that you will support these men in their work. Let each of us continue to do the work Christ has assigned for us, so that the body of Christ in Trinidad and Tobago can be built up to God's honor and glory. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to have some announcements, and then we have a surprise for you guys, so stay tuned.
Good morning. Whether you have logged on from home or elsewhere, or you are here at the Cipriani College in person, we appreciate the time you spent with us at today's worship service. Please take note of the following announcements as we plan for the week ahead. We invite you to worship with us next Sunday from 10 a.m. via the link poscoc.online.church. Join us on Wednesday for part 2 of the series Unbeatable. Starting time is 7 p.m. Zoom meeting ID 852-1115-9801. On Friday, campus devotional starts at 6 p.m. Zoom meeting ID 885-1193-2765. There will be no teens devotional this Friday. Our annual general meeting is scheduled to take place on November 27, 2022. There will be a board overview meeting this Wednesday, September 28th, from 6:30 p.m. At this meeting, you will learn what serving on the board entails. If you are willing to serve in this capacity, kindly submit your name to the church office. Marrieds, I Choose You, Part 2, A Workshop with a Difference, October 22nd, Barataria Regional Complex, 3rd Avenue, Barataria. Interactive activities and a cocktail party, just $500 per couple. Payments can be made via bank transfer or at the church office. Persons making payments via bank transfer must send a screenshot of the transaction information to the office email address, icoctrinidad@gmail.com. The One Ministry presents Singles at Twilight, Saturday, October 15th, 2022, 6:30 p.m. Venue, Nicolette Johnson's residence, 31 Acton Court, Diego Martin. There will be an all-church prayer and fast from October 3rd to 5th. More details will be given at a later date. Let us welcome our youngest brother in Christ, Jaden Richards. He was baptized on Thursday. Jaden is the son of Cheryl Richards. Let us continue to pray for the sick. Let us continue to pray for each other. Those are the announcements.
All right. Jaden is right here with us. Jaden, please stand. Yes, our youngest brother in Christ. Wow. I don't have time to tell the story, but it's amazing what God has done. So praise God for what he's doing. And this is why we do, this is why we're here, brothers and sisters, so we can see more Jadens coming to the church. Amen? Amen. At this time, you all see this dapper looking brother. I mean, my wife thinks I'm awesome, by the way, this way, you know. But I don't know why. Anyhow, but before Ashane takes the mic from me and mash up the place, I'm just joking. We do want to let you all know that to commemorate this time, we have some tokens that we're going to be giving out. The ushers are going to be passing around, and I hope that it will just serve as a memory for this occasion so that we can all look back and see. But of course, we'll have more times like these. Amen? So I give you, Shane, rise on!
Good morning, good morning. Could we please put our hands together for the leader God has appointed to take us through? Make some noise. Make more noise than that. Pastor Nino, I will be asking you to come back in time. Eh? You're trying to duck. You're trying to duck the spotlight, but you're gonna get it again. You know, I just need to say that we have been really blessed in the Caribbean, and with all due respect to all our amazing teachers throughout the world, we have the best teachers right here in the Caribbean. The best. The best. Courtney and Tyrone. No, I want to take a cue from Ronke and say, I too have my bias, but I don't want to get in trouble with Courtney. So I wouldn't call any names. I wouldn't call any names. But this kind of action is higher level activity. When we have appointments such as these, it can only serve to help us take things to a higher level. Anybody ready for a higher level? Yes. Somebody say higher. Higher. Level. Level. All right, you don't need to stand yet. Run tune. All I need for you to do right now is put one hand in the air. And this hand is your light that you're gonna shine proudly wherever you are planted, in Trinidad and Tobago and in the region. When the beat hits, just pump your hand. I know we have timing in the Caribbean, right? Watch it. I just want to say I miss Judah on stage. Just want to say that. Just clap your hands to me like this. I'm not afraid to face the world because I know I'm not alone. These footprints in the sand, they're not mine. I'm in my Father's hands. Cause when I thought I couldn't take it, and everybody said I wouldn't make it, no, Jah lift me up off the ground. Hands up, hands up, hands up. Boom. Here Jah goes again. He took me to a higher level, a higher level. Here Jah goes again. He took me to a... I want you to repeat after me. Somebody say higher level. Higher level. Higher level. Where we got? Somebody say higher level. Higher level. Wheel. Wheel. Pull it. Pull it. Pull it. Pull it. When I say wheel, when I say wheel, you have to go zzzzzzzzzzzzzzz. All right, we need to give them a helping hand in the back. Wheel! Next tune. All I want is a closer walk with you. Holy, one hand in the air like this. I declare every second of this day be devoted to the praise of my Father. Take this day, take it over completely. Lord, I offer it in praise to you. So me say, hallelujah. 24 hours of praise, me do it again in the morning. Hallelujah. 24 hours of praise, and we do it. How can I take it? Father, I'm listening. Father, I'm listening. How can I take it? Father, I'm listening. Father, I'm listening. I wanna take it higher. You are the leader, leader, I will. Follow the leader, leader, you are.
You are the leader, leader, I will. Follow the leader, leader, you are.
You are the leader, leader, I will. Follow the leader, leader, you are.
You are the leader, leader, I will. Follow the leader, leader, you are.
I declare that nobody and no thing gonna come in between me. Me, not today. Better listen when they say nothing coming between me. Hunter, so me say,
hallelujah.
24 hours of praise, and we do it again in the morning.
Hallelujah.
24 hours of praise, and we do it. How can I take it? Father, I'm listening. Father, I'm listening. How can I take it? Father, I'm listening. Father, I'm listening. I wanna take it. I you are the leader, leader, I will. Follow the leader, leader, you are.
You are the leader, leader, I will. Follow the leader, leader, you are.
You are the leader, leader, I will. Follow the leader, leader, you are.
You are the leader.
Put the ones in the air real quick for me. Father, be praised. Be praised. Father, be praised. Be praised. Pull it. Wheel. Yes. Yes. We have a short time, but we have tune to do. Who do we serve? It was Helter Skelter. It was Helter Skelter, to be honest. Who do we serve? Lion or what?
Judah.
All right, all right, all right. Not that Judah. Not that Judah, not you, bro. Why you there in the back, over there in the corner?
wondering about what them people say. Don't you know who you are? You're the son of the daughter of the Most High God, the King of Kings. Come out of the dark. Yes, yes, confidently. Come out of the dark. In key. Come out of the dark. Step into the light. Move to the front. Where you belong. Come out of the dark. Step into the light. Move to the front. Where you belong. Tell me, what is your fate? Tell me, what is your fate? Tell me, what is your fate? Tell me, what is your... Who do we serve? Lion or what? A foreigner? If God be for me, who can be? Tunage. Now you can stand. If you're warmed up, get on your feet. If you're warmed up. By you there in the back, over there in the corner, wondering about what them people say. Don't you know who you are? You're the son of the daughter of the Most High God, the King of Kings. Come out of the dark, step into the light, move to the front, where you belong. Come out of the dark, step into the light, move to the front, where you belong. Tell me, what is your... 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 Who do we serve?
Jesus.
I don't know.
Judah.
I'm foreigner.
Mega.
If God be for me, who... Take a jump on his spot.
I can't get
no. I can't get no. If God be for me,
who can be...
I can't get no. Yo.
I can't get no.
You're the head of the tail, you are more than a conqueror. Everything that you do, expect to win. Don't give up if you fail, don't beat up if you fall. Pick yourself off the ground, repent and win. Come out of the dark, step into the light. Move to the front, where you belong. Come out of the dark, step into the light. Move to the front, where you belong. Tell me, what is your... 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 Who do we serve?
Jesus.
Lion or what?
Judah.
A foreigner.
Mega.
If God be for me, who can be? I can't get no. Hey.
I can't get no.
Hey.
I can't get no.
Now, if God be for... Wheel. We have real DJs out here. Real Christian DJs out here. So before I do this next one, I really want to open the stage for Brother Nino. Yeah. It's important. It's important. And I want to open the floor for our newly appointed deacons as well. Michael London, Neil Carrington, Pastor Coffey, no, Jovi Lord. If you want to, of course, T-Bone, Tyrone, Marcus, if you're wrong, he come in. All right. So this last song, have a dance. Come, T. And our fearless leader, and our teacher is going to help demonstrate the dance. Listen. We have two versions. We have one for people with good knees, and we have one for people with bad knees. So we show you the one with good knees first. Okay? Who got this? You see it? Who got this? You see it? Who got this? You see the difference? So we don't want anybody injuring themselves this morning. Come all the way to the front. Step out of the dark. Make some noise. All right. So when I ask the question once, you answer three times. No dance yet. This is just a warm-up. Who got this?
My Jesus.
perfect. This side was perfect, actually. So let's try it again. Who got this? All right, so this is, I know all you know it. Who got this?
My Jesus.
How do you look there? All right, so you only have to take a jump with me for the first chorus if you want to stay to the end. All right. Tunage. We want to invite Merlin. Take a jump on the spot. This is a celebration. Who got this? Put your hands together like this. The situation that I'm facing is like a giant, and I wonder if I'll make it. Oh, Jesus, help me with my faith quick. I really must admit, Goliath have me shaking. Jesus says, son, remember who I am. Consider what I've done. Them giants up to run. Don't you forget who got this.
My Jesus.
Hey, who got this? Jesus had us under control. All is well in my soul. Jesus had us under control. All is well with my soul. All is, clap those hands to me. I'm back and I'm ready now, man.
Make confidence come back strong.
His hand is not too short to say.
That's why I can stand my throne.
Greater is he who is in me
than he who is in the world.
I know my God will defend me. Jesus said, daughter. Remember, just look how far I brought you from. Them giants have to, don't you forget, who got there?
My Jesus.
Hey, who got there?
My Jesus.
Jesus had us under control. All is well in my soul. Jesus had us under control. All is well in my soul. All is well in my soul. All right. So I see Pastor Nino already. Show you what time it is. We are David, and we're going to take down every Goliath in our lives right now. Put something in the air. Put your sling up to the sky and swing it. Swing it, swing it, swing it round and round. Put your faith in the Most High God. Every single giant in your life, faster! Put your sling up to the sky. Now let it go, let it go. Look Goliath in the eye. Now let it go, let it go, let it go. What?
Who got there?
Jesus had us under control.
Under control.
All is well in my soul.
Under my soul.
Jesus had us under control.
Under control.
All is well in my soul. Pull it. Who got this?
My Jesus.
Hey, who got this? Yeah, who got this?
My Jesus.
Who got this?
My Jesus. Ha! My Jesus. Ha! My Jesus.
Get your confidence back. God bless you. Thank you, brother. We are dismissed.